Sorry. Booting Tom out.
Tom's got a bit of a man flu. So you guys have me this morning.
He's convinced that he's dying because his throat's sore. You know how he is. All right. So we're going to start up with a little bit of stretching. Then we've got a every minute on the minute workout for 10 minutes, and then followed by a little ab circuit. And then I'm going to add our 100 sit-ups onto the end of that, because why not? We have nothing but time these days. But first of all, we're going to do some stretching because the baby slept all night last night, which meant I slept all night last night and I didn't move, which means I now cannot look to the left. So we're going to do some stretching. So the first thing I'm going to do is some cats and cows. So get on your on all fours, stack your shoulders over your hands, try and turn your elbows this way. So try and turn your elbows so that they're facing forward and press your index finger down towards the ground. If you do any like hand balancing, that's a really good tip for you. If you find that you can't hold your handstands, it might be because you've got your first finger popped off the ground. So turn your elbows. Let's do some cats and cows. So I didn't expect that as soon as the baby started sleeping through the night, that my body would just decide that it was going to sleep like the dead all night. But I literally think I fell asleep at 9 and woke up at 7 this morning in the exact same position, which is not good. And if you hear my shoulder popping, I'm sorry for that. It's just a thing that it does. Okay. Now we're going to stand up. And we're going to do just a nice forward fold, like a gentle kind of hanging forward fold. And then you're going to put your finger, your pinky fingers in your elbows and kind of swing back and forth. I always feel like this feels nice everywhere. From my hamstrings all the way down to my neck. Just use the weight of your upper body to pull your head and neck down. Okay, now, if you can, put your hands on the floor. If not, give a little bend to your legs. And then we're going to walk forward into this downward dog position and kind of pedal your legs a little bit. You can sway back and forth. Get your shoulders warmed up a little bit here. Okay, kick one leg up. Step it forward into your lunge. You can drop your leg down in the back. And now we're just going to kind of move around a little bit. Okay, tuck your toes under, straighten. Okay, drop down again. Both hands come to your knee. And you're going to press your back straight. Okay. Try not to let your knee go over your toes. You want to keep it, your knee directly in line over your foot. And now you're pushing up off your knee to keep your back straight and giving yourself a nice stretch through your hip. And I still just feel like I can't look. Okay. Hands go back to the floor. Tuck your leg under, or your toes under, sorry. Kick. And back to your downward dog. Again, you can move around a little bit here. We're going to be doing some press-ups. So, all right, other leg. And step forward. drop down. Breathe for a second here. And again, I'm just kind of moving in between these two positions. Tuck your toes under, hands come to your knee. Back to your downward dog. Okay, this next bit is optional. If you want to do it, you can. If not, you don't have to. We're going to get started on the workout in just a second, but I'm just going to stretch my neck a little bit. So I'm going to put my forehead on the ground, roll up to the top of my head and a little bit past so that I'm forcing my chin to tuck to my chest. Makes it hard to talk. So, okay, just gonna do this a few times. Then I'm gonna pop up and I'm gonna do the same thing. Okay. Now I'm going to roll over and do the same thing. Again, you don't have to do this. Like I said, I just fell asleep and woke up with my neck really bothering me. So, in this position, I'm just trying to roll from the back of my head to the front of my head as far as I can to get the muscles in my neck working, and that actually feels much better. All right, so we have an every minute on the minute workout today. So the first exercise is sprawls, I believe. Let me get my handy book here. Okay, so our first exercise is sprawls. You guys should all know sprawls. Then we've got press-ups, so any variation of press-up you want to do. Don't forget, this is every minute on the minute, so you have to do them quick. So we've got 10 sprawls, 10 press-ups, whatever press-up variation, and then 5 drop steps per side, which are these guys. So that's quite a lot to get done in a minute, but we will persevere. Let me get timer going here. Ugh. I swear, when the baby sleeps well, I'm more tired when I wake up than I am on days when she doesn't sleep well at all. All right. Okay, so again, 10 sprawls, 10 press-ups, 10 drop steps, or 5 per side, whichever you, however you prefer to think about it. I'm turning the heater off. 10 minutes. So after this, we're going to have a 5-minute ab circuit followed by our sit-ups. The sit-ups weren't planned when I planned the workouts this week, so I'm sorry about that, but that's life. So start with sprawls, and let's get started. And then we got press-ups. And then drop steps. Okay. Took me about 30 seconds. As my neck and shoulders warm up, I might switch to regular press-ups. But, man. That baby is going to kill me, I swear. I don't know how parents do this more than once. You guys are crazy. It's insanity. Okay, so I've got 5 seconds. And and raw. Okay, again, about 30 seconds. There we go. I think, who knows? I've got 15 seconds to rest, and then we're off again. So, 5 seconds. 2, 1. And then our drop steps. Okay. I'm slowing down slightly by a couple seconds, or I've slowed down slightly by a couple seconds, which is normal. It's very warm in here. The shed is kind of like, it's kind of like a sauna in the summer, and it's freezing cold in the winter. About 5 seconds. May as well stand up. 2, 1. Okay, I sped it up that time. I managed it in 29 seconds. So I've got, looks like 6 rounds left to go. And yeah, it's going to be a short-ish workout today, but that's all right. We did a longer one yesterday. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Again, I'm averaging, I'd say, probably about 30 seconds for all three of these exercises. My goal is to not slow down much more than that, is to keep that pace throughout and just try and work on recovering in those 30 seconds I have. The last 2 rounds, I might try and speed it up. I've got 5 seconds. I gotta get up. I always end up doing these workouts alone during ones where it's hard to talk. And then it's just, it's quiet in here and there's nobody to talk at you guys. So you know I'm not the one that's normally chattering away. Okay, so we got 3, 2, 1. Okay, 3 minutes left, well, 3 rounds left. I'm exactly the wrong level of sticky right now, where like, you're kind of sweaty, you're just getting stuck to everything instead of sliding. It's the worst. All right, 10 seconds. One and two rounds left, 2.5 minutes left. So these every minute on the minute workouts are hard to plan because you have to plan ones that are hard enough. You don't want them to be easy, but you don't want them to be impossible either. All right, 1 round left. I finished that one in 26 seconds. So I'm gonna try and go faster than that for the last one. And then we'll do our ab circuit and call it a day. Nice short one today. You know, can't be bothered to do super long workouts every day. Nobody has time for that. Real life gets in the way. 2, 1. Ah, good. Okay, I finished that one in 25. So I'll let the time run out. 30 seconds left. You guys are finishing up. Good work. 20 seconds. 15. 10. 10 time. Nice job. Okay, so that was our every minute on the minute workout today. So the next one is an ab circuit. Like I said, one of the exercises is a pike press. So this is a pike press without a press up, just the ab portion of the press. And I'm going to use socks because it's much easier on these mats, but you do not have to use socks. If you have one of those fun little circle slidey things, you can use those. If you're on a hardwood floor, you can just use a dish rag. The mats just have too much friction to do it without socks, but not enough to do it with like a dish rag or a rag or anything like that. So we've got pike presses. We've got 5 pike presses. So that's, let me get into shot here. So from your press up position, it's bringing your feet in to your pike and sliding back. Even these socks aren't quite slippery enough. So the smoother you can get that, the better. I'm fighting a little bit against the mat. It's the puzzle mats for you. Then we've got leg lifts. Okay. So you have any kind of leg lift variation you want. You can do hands under the butt. You can do hands out wide. You can do hands up. Whatever you want. Lift your legs. Try not to drop them at the bottom of the lift. Try and keep them off the ground when you're doing the leg lifts. And then we've got hollow body rocks, I think. Oh, so that's five leg lifts, five pike press, five hollow body rocks, which are these guys. And then, five opposite foot punch per side. So you're going to bring your hand up to your foot and touch it. You're going to do five per side or 10 in total of that one. Or you can just lay here. That's fine too. It's Tuesday, I think, but time has no meaning. So we're going to do that for 5 minutes. And then we're going to do our 100 sit-ups. So that'll be fun. And then we're going to call it a day. It's very warm in here. So what's my first exercise? Pike press-ups. So get your socks, get whatever you need. I might get this giant gift bag here and see if my socks slide better on that. So it was Tom's birthday and he got a grill, and the grill came in a giant gift bag. So I might try and slide on that, see if that is any easier. It might not be. It's all an experiment. And then we'll get started. All three of our family members can fit in this bag. I'm not sure if that says that the bag's too big or if we're all too small. All right, 5 minutes. Starting with your pike press-ups. Ready? Go. Oh yeah, that's way better. And then hollow body rocks. Oh, I hate these. And then, opposite foot punch. Guys, don't mind me, my brain is somewhere else today. And back to our pike presses. And then leg lifts. Now all these abs are killing me. Okay, got 3 minutes left. My giant gift bag is getting a little messed up. It's okay, we sorted it out. Just You'd think that after 8 months, my abs would be back to normal, but no. Okay, so we've got 35 seconds left. And that's time. Okay, let me write down what I got here. I got, all right, so there we go. That's that done. I'm gonna take off my silly socks now. And so at this point, if you'd like to stretch out, you can stretch out. I'd recommend doing some cobras and some upward dogs. You know, these guys, cobras and all that. I am going to do my 100 sit-ups because apparently that didn't count. You know, once Tom gets it in his head, we're going to do something and we have to do it. So I'm going to do those total sit-ups again. As many as I can in the first round, and then, you know, finish out the 100 sit-ups, and you can stay. You're welcome to stay and do them with me or not. Doesn't matter. If you're part of our groups, you know, we're going to be doing our, what's it called? Mobility session tomorrow on Wednesday at 6, and then another jiu-jitsu session on Thursday. But we'll be here in the morning to do the workouts. Okay, I'm just trying to put this off because I really don't want to do it, but we're going to do it. So I'm going to do those total sit-ups again, starting from like a completely outstretched position and then sitting up to like a tuck. And we're off. Thank you. Okay, that's 60. I've got 40 more. I just need a breather. Then we'll get back into it. I'm gonna try and do this last set all in one go. We'll see. See how it goes. Halfway there. Ten more. There's my 100 sit-ups. Nobody can say I didn't do them after the ab circuit. So that was a good little workout. Not as long as usual, but that first bit should have been quite cardio intensive, which was the point. As we get closer to coming back to training, you know, we're still going to add in those strength sessions, but we're going to start adding in some more cardio so that we can build back up to like training stamina, essentially, because I know most people aren't going to be there like at that level when we come back. So that was a good session. If you're part of our group, we'll see you in the mobility session tomorrow. Otherwise, I will see you guys tomorrow.